Hey guys, how's it going? It's been a long time since I made a video, and it's going to be a very long time since I do another one. And we'll get into that in just a bit. But about 4 years ago, I made a video talking about Trump, and it was called something about a theory of a bullshit. I'll put a link in the description to the original video. So basically 4 years ago, I made a video saying that we're going to get a test of a bullshit theory, and I think it's bullshit, and my friend encouraged me to do it, one of the co-hosts of my podcast, which he's coming back, don't worry, to Sauce, and he's also coming back with a YouTube channel, so that's going to be great. But he inspired me to make this video talking about this theory that was going around a lot of libertarians in regards to voting for libertarians voting for Trump. And a lot of it had to do with circling around immigration. And I basically said that, look, this is not going to work out. You're wasting your fucking time voting for Trump, thinking that he's going to bring some sort of libertarian utopia or help push us in the right direction because of his stance on immigration. and the idea was that to kind of summarize the video, basically, and I made a few other predictions as well, that immigrants, especially ones coming from Mexico, tend to vote Democrat. And because they vote Democrat, it's going to increase the size and scope of government. And that if we vote for someone like Trump, that it'll foster the kind of libertarian mentality that we can actually move towards a libertarian society. And I want to talk a little bit now that the Trump presidency is over. I voted for Trump in the second election. I was not a fan of him to begin with until I saw how he actually worked out. So I have some good things to say about Trump, and I have some very bad things to say about Trump. But overall, I think the Trump presidency was the best president that I've ever seen in my lifetime. But the bar is really low. It doesn't take much for you to be the best president of the United States in my lifetime. And that started with Reagan. So let's talk about the things that I got right, right? Or excuse me, the things that I got wrong. I said that Trump, so I didn't actually say this specifically. I didn't say that he was not going to slash regulations or he was going to slash regulations. But I did say that he was not going to be able to shrink the size and scope of government, but he did do that in one respect, and not very well, and that was slashing regulations. So Donald Trump did slash a lot of regulations while he was in office. He wasn't very effective in it. The reason why he wasn't very effective in it is because he had a lot of Obama holdovers, and because he had a lot of Obama holdovers, a lot of those people were writing in new legislation. However, the amount of regulation that happened under Trump, even though it exceeded the amount that that he was slashing, there still was some being left, and a lot of the regulations that were being written in were kind of like revising some regulations that they thought that they needed to have in lieu of some of the regulations that were slashed, so that, you know, you don't get sort of like a imbalance of things, right? So, you know, you don't want to cut Obamacare. Right, like you don't want to cut like you know, the individual mandate for Obamacare, because then you made a death spiral. Oh wait, no, they did that. Getting ahead of myself, but they were kind of doing those sorts of regulations. But if you look at the graph of, you know, presidents and the regulations, you see like a slight upturn, and then Donald Trump's down here. So that is a good thing, right? Even just tampering down the amount of regulations that happen in a presidency is always a great thing. And so I'm going to give him a good on that. What did I get right, though? Everything else. I think I got right everything else. I'm going to save immigration for last. I'm going to focus on, let's focus on the good stuff, right? So the court appointments, like Donald Trump was lucky enough to get three court appointments. He got Gorsuch, Kavanaugh, and ACB after the passing of Antonin Scalia. I forget who else went. And then we also got the death of Ruth Bader Ginsburg. I can't talk for some reason. And so we got replacements for Gorsuch, Kavanaugh, and ACB. Gorsuch, Kavanaugh, a little bit better. ACB, a whole lot better. So they've been progressively getting better along the way. So we got that. That's good. It's going to be bad in other ways, but I think that usually Republican court appointments are a little bit better. And my stance on abortion is I'm pretty much off the fence now. I'm pretty much pro-life, pretty much, for all intents and purposes. Donald Trump was very good about, I'm not going to say foreign policy, but he's been very good about war. He's been the first president in my lifetime that has not started a brand new war. That is amazing. That is great. And good for Donald Trump for not getting us into another quagmire. I am very happy about that. I will take what I can get. Now, he also pulled some troops, I believe, out of Iraq and Afghanistan and some other conflicts that we were in. That's great. However, he didn't do that with Syria or Yemen. I'll take what I can get. However, I do think Dave Smith is right. He is a war criminal, and he deserves to be in a cell right next to George Bush and Obama and Bill Clinton. And if he was still alive, George H.W. Bush and Reagan. Let's see. Taxes. That's another good thing he was good about. He did slash taxes. Not a lot, but enough. However, that's kind of counterbalanced by something else we're going to talk about when we get into the negative. The bully pulpit. He's been very good about the bully pulpit. He's been really kind of going after bad aspects and bad actors. Both in the media and in the culture. So that's been good. Like he's been, and I'm always a big fan of trolling. I'm always a great fan of trolling, no matter what. Though some of his actions on Twitter, that's a whole other story. Basically, that could have led us into some problems. However, it didn't. So I can't say that it's bad that he did that, because it could have gotten us into a problem when it didn't. So that theory is out. So regulations we already talked about. So he's been good about regulations. He's been throttling and removing a lot of regulations, so that's really great. But unfortunately, that's where the compliments end, and we need to talk about the bad things. So first and foremost, the shit that's been going on in Yemen and Syria, absolutely condemnable on every single level, and that alone to me makes someone not worthy of any praise. Overall, specifics, things that we've talked about, some of the good things that he did, were good. But honestly, if I had to pick like two big issues with, right, like if there was two big issues that I like to focus on more, the most is getting rid of the Federal Reserve. That's, and war. I don't think I would prioritize, I probably would prioritize the Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve is kind of the basis for a lot of us getting into war, which, by the way, now the sun is up. You know what? I'm going to wear my, the original sips was Arizona iced tea. So I'm going to wear my Arizona glasses instead of my proper glasses. Man, these suck. Whatever. We're going to wear my Arizona. Fuck it. You can barely even see in those things. They're not even clean. I'll wear my real glasses now. So anyways, so that's already makes me hate the guy on every level. Working with the House, he's been absolutely fucking terrible. He's been really bad about crossing the aisle. And it's also has to do with the fact that, you know, he's so caustic to the left that it's impossible for him to reach across the aisle and work with Democrats on anything, even with things that they want, including like more stimulus payments. We'll get more into spending in just a bit. But he's been absolutely bad with that. He's also been really bad about working with his own party. His own party has been not particularly happy with him as well. Foreign policy, he has not been very good diplomatically working with other nations. He is not, sorry. And, you know, foreign aid and things like that, he did not curb at all, which is a big problem. It causes a lot of problems, especially in developing nations who take that money and then use that money to use food as a weapon, which is not good. Although he did kind of open up talks with North Korea. Credit where credit's due. The swamp. Kind of interesting that he kind of focused a lot of his campaign rhetoric around draining the swamp. And then he let in people like John Bolton. And in my video, he was talking about working with Mitt Romney. That didn't work out. But I would much take I would take Mitt Romney over fucking John Bolton any day. A lot of the people that he still had in his administration were, a lot of them were fucking Obama holdovers. That's not draining the swamp. It's really fucking not. And it's rather unfortunate that he didn't do any of that stuff, because the swamp was one of the things that we all hoped that he would do, and he didn't do that. And in fact, we kind of got, I wouldn't say more of the same. We got less of the same. I think that would be, I think that would be a better way to describe this administration. Spending. What's the point of lowering taxes if we're just going to pump up inflation and then have all of our prices rise as a result? COVID-19, all the stimulus payments revolving around COVID-19. Everybody got a check. Everybody got a bag. Fucking not as much as what I thought it was going to end up being, on par with something that Andrew Yang would want. But he gave us one bag, promised more, never gave us more. He did give us a $600 one, like, what, 9 months later? Not that I wanted it. Not that I think it was a good idea. I'm just saying that he didn't. It's a matter of fact. It's not a matter of want, right? I'm just stating facts, not stating my opinion about that. My opinion is $0 should have gone out, because there should have been no lockdowns. But the lockdowns were not under his control. If anybody was going to be responsible for a lockdown and payments to people who were affected by the lockdowns, it should have been the states and not the federal government bailing out the states for doing it, for doing something stupid. But he also encouraged all the lockdowns as well. So, and he kept Fauci on, even after he knew Fauci was a fucking fraud. He's a fucking quack. Ban my account. It's the truth. He's a fucking quack. Every fucking goddamn 5 minutes, he's contradicting himself. He's not following the science, and he keeps saying stupid shit, like you gotta wear 3 masks because some fucking students at Virginia Tech thought it would be a good idea. And did some asshattery anybody who knows, anybody who's been through medical school of any stripes, even CNAs will tell you, don't wear 2 masks. It actually makes things worse. It actually exposes you to more microbes, because you're basically creating a swamp in front of your mouth when you wear 1 mask. When you wear 2 masks, it's even worse. That was one of the things they told me. Don't think you're being smart by wearing 2 masks. It only makes things worse. That's what I was told. That's what I was told in CNA's class. Imagine what they would tell you in nursing class. I'll tell you what they'll tell you in nursing class, because my parents were nurses. My grandmother was a nurse. And my great-grandmother was actually one of the first students in the nursing programs when they first offered it in California. Don't wear 2 masks. It's a stupid idea. And now he's telling you to wear 3. He's a crank. He's a quack. He might as well be writing for Americola. Or fucking Natural News. So, yeah, spending. So we're gonna, because he lowered taxes, great. That's always good. But he increased the most insidious tax of all, which is, inflation and the price rises that, come as a result. Let's see. I should have been a doctor. Immigration. Let's talk about immigration for a bit. So Donald Trump talked a big game about how he was going to curb immigration, and not much was done. Little things here and there, mostly tokens, a little bit of a wall that, you know, people could just walk around, a little bit of a little bit more regulations about, who can be let into the country. But for all intents and purposes, Donald Trump pretty much did nothing. And a lot of the people who were part of the alternative right movements were also very upset with him, even so much so that official CNN commentator Richard B. Spencer actually endorsed Joe Biden for president. So, I mean, and we'll get into a rant, hopefully, if I can remember, because you know how I am. Free trade. He's been absolutely terrible about free trade. Fortunately, he's not very effective on acting on pretty much anything, but on that especially. So it's a good thing we have free trade. The populist movement is always wrong about free trade. They always want to restrict it. They always want things like, you know, free trade policies that basically prevent companies from outsourcing products overseas. Outsourcing is a good thing. Displacement of labor in the short run is not very good for workers, but in the long run it's good for not only them but for everybody. Sorry, Trudeau Tom is completely wrong about comparative advantage. Let's see, monetary policy. This one's a mixed bag. Donald Trump kind of really got people starting to talk about the Federal Reserve and whether or not it's possible for you to fire the chairman of the board, and that got the Federal Reserve kind of in the talk. Though a lot of the talk was not, let's get rid of the Fed, but it did allow for a lot of people to have that conversation. As far as monetary policy outside of that, he's not been very different from any other president, and the stimulus payments, again, were part of that. I did not hear about any new rounds of QE. There were talks of it for a little bit, but I don't think anything ever panned out. And QE has a bunch of money sitting in the bank from QE4 that's never been lent out because people were skeptical about housing. But it looks like that's making a turnaround, and now we're going to be facing another recession because of that. Fantastic. And I really can't read this last one. Oh, I think, okay, never mind, I already covered that. So, yeah, I think that's pretty much it. So, on the whole, Trump's been the best president that I've lived through, but that's not saying much because all the presidents I've lived through have been hot trash, and they should be in jail, if not hung, for the war crimes that they committed around the world, their fiscal irresponsibility, and the like. Trump's been better than most on a lot of these things, worse in some ways. He's not been a very effective president, not very effective at all, and mostly because that's not his forte. His forte is shitposting on Twitter, and now he can't even do that. And there has been some side effects that you can't really blame him. You can only really blame the reaction to him, like all of the social media purges and all that stuff. That's the only thing that we can, you know, point to and say that, you know, this was really a negative on the whole, is all of this stuff. But you can't really blame other people for having such a visceral negative reaction that they go so insane that they would do all this stuff. But whatever, the whole woke thing, I feel deserves a whole other deep dive into when I start doing more live streams and stuff like that. But yeah, so I'm going to touch on this immigration thing that I kind of mentioned earlier. Look, when it comes to things like immigration, and I know a lot of people on my subscribers are very big fans of trying to curb immigration because they think that that's going to put us in the right direction for having a libertarian society. I think it's a completely futile effort. And the reason why it's a completely futile effort is because there's too much money from big corporations who want to see cheap labor come into this country. And so they fight and they do everything that they can to make sure that cheap labor comes into this country. Like, why should they pay an American-born person who wants, you know, minimum wage to go out in the field and, you know, pick cabbage when they can hire someone who just came across the border and they can pay him pennies on the dollar, and they can live a better life that way. So you're not going to end up, better life in, as compared to, you know, where they came from. So trying to fight this immigration as a step forward, as a way to get to address two completely axillary type problems, which is the welfare state and democracy, I think it's better just to attack the root rather than try to focus on this immigration thing. I have a different tactic on immigration. I'm even though I am very much open borders, I don't feel that it is a that it is the that it, for, tactically, I don't think that it's something that's worth addressing right now. I think there's much more important things on the table, especially getting like lowering all of these social safety nets and ruining the idea, the terrible idea that is democracy. I think that's much more important. So, I don't know if I mentioned this at the top. I know I mentioned this in the Patreon only. Or we're on Locals now. We're moving over to Locals. Lulberts.locals.com. We're not going to be doing Patreon after February. But behind the paywall, I just did a podcast talking about some of this stuff. But I'm going to be done doing short videos from now on. This was probably going to be my last one. Unless something compels me to make another video. But I'm going to be focusing more on streaming and podcasting. I think that's where I do better. I think that's where I do better work is when, and people tell me that they prefer my, my long form content over my short form content. It's not to say that this is, you know, this is done. But I think I addressed a lot of the issues that I had, in the world, both with, you know, communism and socialism and even in inner libertarianism, conservatism and liberalism and all this other stuff. I think I've addressed all the issues that I wanted to cover. All of the other things that I could cover are things that people other libertarians have said a million times before and possibly even better. So what's the point? There are some things that I do want to cover, and if I do cover them, I'm going to want to cover them in a long form format and with someone else and having a discussion. I think that's where I do better. I do better work that way than I do with doing solo short form content. So this is kind of my sayonara. I'm still going to be active on my YouTube channel. Obviously I'm going to be streaming, but I'm going to be focusing more on getting the Lulberts back. The Lulberts is coming back to this channel. This is where we're going to be hosting it from now on. The other channel, we're just going to just let it, you know, rot on the vine. So all the Lulbert stuff. And then we're going to be kind of rebranding this channel to be much more in line with the Lulberts brand rather than the Jim Jesus brand. I think I want to not just, you know, give a platform to myself, but also give a platform to other creators that would want to collaborate with me doing podcasts and live streams and that sort of thing. Just another quick little update. This is not going to be very topical. This is very topical. It's not going to be very relevant, in a month or two, but we're not going to do a desert bus run this month. We're going to do two in February. Things has been just been crazy with work and rebranding and everything. So that's what we're doing from now on. So get prepared for two desert bus runs next month, or we may do another 16-hour run. But you got a 16-hour one last time, even though we only get 12 hours recorded. We're also going to be focusing more on other alternative platforms, so stay tuned for that. But this is going to be kind of the end of the line for the Jim Jesus channel, and we're going to be ushering in another world of Lulberts Media. But anyways, I will talk to you guys later. Hail Satan and worms.